So in some sneaker news, Adidas issued a warning. They beefing. They issued a warning to Nike at the Footwear News Achievement Awards. Did you see that?
I did. The CEO of Adidas, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh. You know, I don't know if Adidas is in the right place to shoot.
Yeah, bro. What are y'all thinking? Come on now. Let's say going to go get Ye back. But they got something big up their sleeve.
I don't know what they got going on. I'm anxious to see now. But if y'all didn't know, Adidas CEO, I don't know how to pronounce his name. So
Jorn Gould.
I don't know if he was just accepting an award or was on stage for something or whatever it was.
The Samba was awarded Shoe of the Year.
Oh, Samba was Shoe of the Year. Oh, so that hyped him up.
What?
So, obviously, Kenan doesn't agree.
That's wild.
But the Adidas CEO states, Nike, watch out. We have a lot in the pipeline for 2024. Did he call him out?
Yeah.
He didn't call him out.
He said, yeah.
He said Nike.
He said Nike by name.
Oh, we have a lot in the pipeline for 2024.
It must have been serving. It must have been an open bar at that moment.
I don't know, man, but them some, he writing some mighty big checks, you know what I'm saying, that his bottom has to cash.
He went Suge Knight style, the Source Awards.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, if you don't want people out in your videos.
Dancing.
You know, meanwhile, my dude Larry Miller from JB, the chairman of Jordan Brand, you know, he came back Andre 3000 style and said, Jordan Brand got something to say. So he said, bring it on. We're ready for you. To the people and the brands that called us out earlier.
Mm.
So, you know, as we discussed plenty of times here, man, and I can speak for my brother here. I go out on a limb. We team Nike and Jordan Brand.
Yeah,
while we do love the other brands, man, we appreciate the stuff that they bring out, appreciate the great product that they have here in the store. Just born and raised Jordan and Nike kids, man.
Unfortunately, you know.
And it's like they're...
we like some Adidas.
Yeah, we like some Adidas.
We like
brand
more
stuff.
Jordan and Nike stuff.
Yeah, and it... Tangent. So, me being big into marketing, bro, it's hard not to like Nike.
Yeah.
Did you see this new Dion commercial?
I did.
This is why Nike is who Nike is. So, in the Dion commercial, in case y'all don't know, Dan will play a clip of it here.
Now, let me tell y'all something about dreams. Listen up, because this is something I found out a long time ago that goes against everything you see in a movie, on TV, or what your great-grandma may have told you when you were a kid. See, dreams don't happen overnight. That ain't how it works. See, they come to you in the daylight. You got to be awake. Because, baby, you got to run dreams down. See, that chase is where we learn the most about ourselves. To take that extra step, that extra mile, that extra rep. Now look here. You don't never know how long it's gonna take or exactly what it'll look like when you get there. The only thing you know is you can never stop. So, question time, what's your dream? Are you willing to do what it takes to make that dream a reality? No. See, not while you're sleeping, but every darn day you wake up. Because if it does, good morning. Now give me my darn theme music.
Yeah. So it's basically a Nike ad, and Dion has just been back on Nike like a year or so. Mm-hmm. They squashed their beef. But Nike always finds the opportunities.
Seems like they don't miss an opportunity.
They don't. Nike is really big on like finding solutions and not just calling out problems. Like they're really big on, they're a real goal-oriented company and solution-oriented. So while everybody's taking shots at Dion, saying, oh, he had a losing season, oh, everybody's in the transfer portal, blah, 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 Nike and Dion got together and released a commercial stating, hey, a dream don't happen overnight, playboy. You got to put that work in and eventually it'll happen, you know what I'm saying? And to me, that hit home because, you know, back in my day, I was the oratorical contest champion at my elementary school because it's what happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun?
Get your shit fester up, man.
Like a sore and then run? That's just a sample, man. Y'all, hey, man. Y'all looked it up, man. Dream deferred, man. Y'all looked it up. But nah, man, Nike hit that out the park, bro.
I beat you up in elementary school being an oratorical. What's how you say it?
It was the oratorical contest where you memorize a poem and you state it. But you wouldn't.
Shout out to all the real men in the spelling bees.
Straight up. I was in spelling bees, oratorical contests, played football, and I could fight.
As president.
Yeah, and I could fight. So, yeah, I mean, it's just.
Knitting club, the cooking club, what else?
And I played the violin.
Mm-hmm.
God was good to me and still is. Hey,
violin album coming soon.
Straight up. Number freestyles and violin. But all that to say, man, Nike is an incredible company. So for Adidas CEO to be like, watch out, we got something for you.
I mean, it make you think. Like, he might got something.
Yeah.
Hopefully it wasn't his Fear of God stuff they released the other day. There's a lot of bad reviews going on about that, but, you know, let's keep going.
Man, they're sold out.
Yeah, they did sell out.
Of course they gonna sell out. They supposed to sell out.
Nah, shout out them for believing in his company, though. It's kind of hard to believe what he said, because it's the same guy who was just like, basically, and not verbatim, but we love Kanye. Oh, you know? We don't love Kanye. He's not a good guy. So, you know, I don't know, man. But, like, their feud even spilled over to, you know, some Adidas and Nike signature athletes, which was pretty funny because my boy, what's his name?
Edwards.
Yeah, Anthony Edwards was like, man, I would love to see KD play in my signature shoe.
Before you get into that, you said how Nike, you know, do good marketing, good commercials.
Right, right.
That Anthony Edwards commercial, dog. Come on now. You can't put that out and then come say you got something for Nike in the pipeline. That Anthony Edwards commercial was terrible. But go ahead.
You know how I know? Because it's my shoe crazy, man.
Man, go ahead.
Yeah, they got this, man, I don't know. Like I said, Nike is amazing. Nike, working for Nike Marketing and Advertising Department was my dream job growing up. And they do a lot of work with Wieden and Kennedy, who's the advertising agency. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if it's Wieden and Kennedy that come up with amazing ideas or Nike in-house or a combination of the two. But either way, shout out to them. But yeah, man, so he was like, I would love to see KD in my signature shoe. You know my boy KD. Shout out to Longhorn alum. He on Twitter. His Twitter finger stay ready from his account or a burner account. Either way, they gonna get it.
Him and Meek Mill top two on Twitter, man. Go ahead.
So KD responds, you won't ever, in all caps, see me put a big toe in them MFs. So Adidas took it on themselves to respond to KD and say, you dusty, about to retire soon anyway from the official Adidas account.
That's true. And it did not end there. They also came back and said, meant to post that on our burner account. And if anybody knows Twitter and KD, they know my man had the burner account going crazy back in the day.
Right.
And so that was another shot at KD.
You're not that cute. You look dusty.
Now, I will say that was amazing social media work by Adidas. Shout out to my boy Dez at nicekicks.com for actually getting this going, actually. He was the one that posted about So, yeah, he was the one that brought it to their attention. So, shout out to Adidas social media team for making that happen. Like, that brings me back. You remember, I don't know if you remember back when, like, McDonald's and Wendy's and stuff was going at it on social media.
Yes, bro.
What a time, man. Adidas, I think Wendy's probably was, like, one of the first big companies that I remember, like, really showing a
free shout-out. Shout-out to X, man. Greatest app ever.
Yeah. I think Wendy's was, like, one of the first companies that I can remember seeing that actually show personality on social media.
Yes, definitely.
You know, like, it's a real person behind this. It's not just, come check out our new 4 for $4 meal.
Yeah, they blah, was blah, blah, hard, blah, blah.
But, yeah, that was fun times. But, again, Interested to see what Adidas has in the pipeline. You kind of mentioned the new Fear God athletic stuff that just dropped. It released over the weekend. According to Jerry Lorenzo, he thinks the Fear God athletics could be as big as Nike's Jordan brand.
All righty. Shout out to Jerry Lorenzo, man. It's good for you.
Yeah, yeah.
yeah, that's all right. That's cool. Shout out to Jerry, man.
You supposed to believe in yourself.
Yeah,
you
definitely.
Know what I'm saying?
Who, if you don't believe in yourself, who will believe in you?
Feel like he'll listen to a lot of R. Kelly. I'm the world's greatest. I believe I can fly.
As a retailer, how did you think the pricing was?
I don't know the pricing, but you know a little bit of it.
Yeah, so I don't know the name of it, but his top basketball model was 250. He had like a form 86. That was 200, and then he had like a skate shoe with a similar upper to the form 86 that was like 170.
I think that's on par with his brand. I don't think that's nothing out of the ordinary.
Yeah, but are Adidas customers, are they Fear God customers? And not essentials, like Fear God.
Right. That's
Fear
the
God
question.
Is expensive. I mean, it's really expensive.
I mean, I think that's who his market is, though. I mean, that's who his brand targets. Like you say, he's a luxury brand, so he's trying to combine the luxury with the basketball and performance world and see what happens. I mean, but his Nike shoe was, like $250
or something? It was $250.
Nah, I think, man, like I say, again, I think his brand is luxury, but he also understand, like, hey, a lot of people who can't afford this, like my brand, too.
They still want to support.
Right. I don't think it's any difference than, Michelin is making a swing, man. It's like, everybody can't afford that authentic, right. But I want to throw a jersey, too, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, or Nike, my bad, Nike making a swing, man. You know what I'm saying? Compared to the authentic jerseys, you got to cater to different markets. Like, so I'm not mad at that. Just like back in the day, how Nike would make the Gary Payton shoe. And then you had that flight that looked just like that joint itself.
Up tempo, more up tempo.
The
takedown version, basically.
Yeah, your Gary Payton dunk, they just with a Velcro. you like them, huh, Raven? You like that sound effect? But, I mean, you know, like I say, I'll watch them, keep an eye on them. I'd love to have it here at the shop. I think they will sell.
You think that is a void filler for Adidas?
No, because the void is the void left by Kanye.
Yeah, that's a hard void to fill.
Well, he thinks he could be Jordan brand. Kanye was definitely like Adidas Jordan brand.
And I think kicking it could be Jordan brand.
Oh, hell yeah. All right.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. You supposed to believe in your brand like that. If you don't, who will? So, shout out Jerry Lorenzo.
Shout out my nigga Jerry.
you know what I'm saying?